गौर सर्वचतुरामित निधि गौरम सर्व भगवान गौतम रक्षा हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपीकांत राधाकांत नमोस्तुते दप्त कांचन गौरंगे राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्वभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये भक्त्या विहीना यमराज लक्ष्मी क्षिप्तस्य कामादितरं वन्दे कृपामयीतं शरणं प्रपन्नं वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवा सारी गौर भक्त वृंदा सभी कहिए बोलो हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे जोर से
हरे राम So those who are thirsty for Hari Katha, those who are very thirsty for Hari Katha, a thirsty person, he just searches for water and he gets his thirst quenched. Then he does not really worry whether it rained or not. He, to quench his thirst, see this word, pipasa bhujana means quenching the thirst. One quenches fire, so thirst also gets quenched. Yes, through water, thirst gets quenched. In the same way, such kind of thirst, if we develop for Hari Katha, then Krishna is not very far. Just there is a requirement to give a spark to this thirst. So we give spark to thirst also. What is this? Hari Katha Pipasa. If this becomes the support system of our life, then there is no doubt. Chindanti Sarva Sanshaya. All kinds of doubts and all kinds of confusions, they get removed. That Lord, catching whom we want to put in our heart, he can actually come without invitation as well. Sadhyo means at the very moment. You will say that the Lord is present in our hearts. Yes, he is sitting. But he is sitting in the form of Paramatma. He is Supreme Lord. He is Lord only, but he does not perform any pastime. There is only one task that he performs, that is witnessing. He witnesses our karmas. In the tree, like two birds are sitting. In Upanishads it has been said, one bird is eating fruit and another bird is the witness. That's it. Jivatma Paramatma like this. He does not perform any pastime. He does not show his opulence or sweetness. But he is present in our heart. But what is the glory of bhajan that it makes that Shri Krishna sit in our heart? And for that, sadhyo hridaye avidutati kritibhi takshanat shushrushya takshanat. There has been an instruction to hear Bhagavatam. Listen, see, 7-day Bhagavat program, there are different ways to conduct that. For example, there are different ways to conduct marriages, different ways to celebrate birthday. In the same way, different ways of Bhagavad Ji also. Now let me ask you guys, let me ask you all, you are hearers, you are very worshipable for the speaker. Why? Because the speaker is that instrument through which hearers are that instrument through which the speaker can actually sing some glories of the Lord. If the hearers are not there, then how it will work? So as for speaker, hearers are worshipable, in the same way the speaker is worshipable for the hearers. You all are hearers, you are very worshipable. In Delhi, it has been red alert. It's like flood everywhere, so much rainfall, but still you all have come. I am really surprised. Tamal Prabhuji, he came upstairs and I said that no one must have come. He said, no, 200 people are there. He said, I thought that only 10 people must have come. So please clap hands for yourself. This is a great austerity to come in such rainfall. So you are all very worshipable. And you are, I am your servant. So you only tell me. There are two types of ways of discussing, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. One style is just touching each topic. Just touching each topic, little bit. Or, this is one style, touching each topic and covering whole Bhagavatam. And then second style is taking one topic and then just churning that very nicely. What Shukadeva Goswami is saying, what Srila Jiva Goswami is saying, what Acharyas are saying, what Chaitanya Charitamrita is saying. So churning it, and then the butter that is coming out, that is the essence, and that is very great. So it depends on you, what style you want. So later don't complain that, oh, this pastime was not covered, that pastime was not covered. See, I am touching all the topics. This is a style. This is an art. I will not leave any topic. I will touch it, but I will touch in a different way. So do you want it like this? Everyone is agreeing with this. Now I will not be at fault. Now I will openly speak. Srila Shukadeva Goswami, in the yesterday's prasanga we were hearing how he also attained oneness with Radhaji and he attained Krishna's mercy as well. He had darshan of all pastimes of Radha Krishna. Who is he? A parrot. A bird, a parrot. He had darshan of all pastimes. And now the time came when Sri Radha Krishna both finishing their pastimes, they are going back to their eternal abode. What is that abode? गोलोक एव निवासति अखिलात्म भूत गोविंद आदि पुरुषम तमहम भजामि। दे आर रेजिडेंट्स ऑफ गोलोक। व्हेन दे गॉट रेडी टू फिनिश देयर पास्ट टाइम सो दे टोल्ड दिस शुक दिस पैरट दैट यू स्टे हियर यू डोंट गो विद अस यू डोंट कम विद अस। दैट शुक स्टार्टेड क्राइंग। ओ प्रभु ओ राधा कृष्ण यू आर टेकिंग ऑल योर एसोसिएट्स एंड गोइंग बैक टू योर इटर्नल अबोड व्हाई यू आर लिविंग दिस अनफॉर्चुनेट रेस्ट सोल इन दिस अर्थ प्लैनेट। द वे अयोध्या मास्टर दैट इज श्री राम ही टुक ऑल हिज एसोसिएट्स एंड वेंट बैक टू साकेत धाम बट लेफ्ट हनुमान जी बिहाइंड। ओ हनुमान जी You have witnessed our pastimes, so you stay here and glorify our pastimes. Spread its glories. If you will not do, who will do? And Hanumanji also said like that Prabhu, what offense did I do that you are putting me in this pool of separation from yourself? And you are going without taking me. But Ramji's order is the topmost. This is the great foundation, that is serving one's worshipable master. So try to understand this. Atma indriya priti vancha tate bale kaam, Krishna indriya priti ichha dhare prem naam. This is a formula which you should always apply in your life. We are all sadhakas, practitioners. Try to understand. What is tasteful to my senses? What is tasteful to my mind? That is lust. That's not love. But that task in which Krishna's senses are getting satisfied, that is love. Every love requires a sacrifice. And that sacrifice is that foundation on which the palace of love can be built. In every love, there is a sacrifice. And the more that sacrifice increases, the love, the palace will become more beautiful. The love spontaneously will keep on increasing. We do not have to put separate endeavors. You can just see in the family also, the wife, she sacrifices so much for the husband. Husband sacrifices for the wife. Whole day working, coming back in the evening and then serving. They don't have to say to each other that please love me. It is very spontaneous, very natural. In the same way, Atmendriya Priti Vancha, if we just observe this in the spiritual sense, spiritual life, it has a very great fly. Very high fly. Whatever is tasteful and blissful to my senses, that is lust. And whatever is useful, whatever is satisfying to my Lord's senses, that is prem, that is love. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is present in Jagannath Puri with all his eternal associates. He is performing beautiful pastimes, performing playful pastimes in Narendra Sarovar, chanting and dancing in front of Jagannath ji and all his associates under his guidance. They are relishing that pastimes. They are watching Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is crying. It is not an ordinary crying. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it has been described. Mahaprabhu's tears are coming like a jet of water, a spray, a stream. Streams of tears are coming out and the close associates, they are coming nearby. They want to get drenched. They want to get completely soaked in those tears. But if we just keep all these associates in one side of the balance and on the other side of the balance, we keep our six Goswamis. Shri Roop, Shri Sanatan, Shri Bhatt Raghunath, Jeeva Gopal Bhatt Dasa Raghunath. So all associates, they are very special. But these six Goswamis and among them also Shri Rupa and Shri Sanatana Goswami, they are much, much superior than other associates. Why? What's the reason? Mahaprabhu gave this order, go to Vrindavan. and do all these tasks. They also could have said that all your associates are with you living in Jagannath Puri. What was our offense and fault because of which you are sending us away from yourself? But the happiness that is present in the fulfilling the order of one's worshipable master is actually real love. So it's not that those who are living nearby, they are loving. No. These personalities, they kept the orders of Mahaprabhu as the topmost. Why? Krishna Indri Priti Vancha Dhare Premanam. My worshipable master, my worshipable East, whom I love so much. In his happiness is my happiness. That's why he went away. He went far away. Srila Rupa Goswami is sitting so far from Mahaprabhu in Vraj and obeying his orders. And because of this, Srila Rupa Goswami became Priya Swarupe, Daita Swarupe, Prema Swarupe, Sahaj Rupe. And Sri Chaitanya Mano Bheshtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale. This is a title which Srila Rupa Goswami has been reserved for that, with that title. This title reserved for Srila Rupa Goswami. He is the personality who fulfilled the heart, who fulfilled the innermost desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Such strong bonding they have with each other that Rupa Goswami can see what is going on in the heart of Mahaprabhu. Why? Because Krishna Andri Priti Vancha Dhare Premanam, such a great sacrifice. They were present on such great positions. Shri Rupa and Sanatana Goswami, they are Pradhan Mantri, Prime Minister, Finance Minister. And they left all their opulence, all their wealth, everything at once. Tyaktva Durna Mashesha Mandalam Patir Shrinim Sadatuchava Bhutva Dina Ganesha. Vande Rupa Sanatana Bhatayugo Shri Jeeva Gopalako. That sacrifice that they did, that sacrifice is nothing. That is Tvaktva Turnam Ashesha Mandalapati. They actually sacrificed it like a blade of grass. But what is the height of the pinnacle of sacrifice of Srila Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami? The pinnacle of their sacrifice is this, that leaving aside the physical association of their worshipable master whom they love so much and following his orders by staying away. You are in service of Guruji. Who wants to leave? And if Guruji says go away, go there on in Delhi and just manage Sri Raman Vihari Gaudiya Math. It's a great sacrifice. Leaving physical association of Guruji, not the heartly association. Srila Gurudev and our all Acharya, Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaji, Vrindavan is closer to their own life. Gurudev never wanted to leave Mathura, never wanted to leave Vraj. But love requires sacrifice. It demands sacrifice. Considering the order of Guru Maharaj Ji, Mahaprabhu, as the topmost, leaving aside their dearmost place and then going all over the world and establishing Braj Bhav. So that love demands sacrifice. Without sacrifice, there is no love. Love is sacrifice, and sacrifice is love. Krishnendri Priti Vancha Dhare Premanam. Srila Shukadeva Goswami, he begged, he prayed, but the order of Supreme Lord, and above that, order of Srimati Radharani, that, O Shuka, O my parrot, what my beloved Shri Krishna is saying, please follow those words. And there, Srila Shukadeva Goswami, he just got silenced. He could not say anything further. She tried to understand two things. O Shuka, if you if you glorify our past times, then don't speak about my name. Don't give my name anywhere. And second, the mood with which I have said something to my prana priya shri Shyam Sundar, according to that mood only you should speak, you should give that mood. Don't add anything from your own moods. So these two things Radha ji, these two orders Radha ji told to Shuka. So Srila Shukadeva Goswami, in an indirect way, he is glorifying Radha ji, but he is following the orders of Radha ji that I am not allowed to write the name of Radha ji. And the words and the moods that I have expressed, please give those pastimes and narrate those pastimes with the same moods. This is not an easy task. When you eat someone's remnants, then it's easy to glorify that personality's glories. It's easy. But it's actually very difficult to hide those glories of that personality whose remnants we eat. I again and again tell this, that speaking Bhagavatam as it is very easy. But simplifying Bhagavat and then speaking is very difficult. In the same way, if we speak those moods, that is very simple, that's very easy. Exactly. But when there comes a point where we have to explain something to someone, then we have to simplify things, and when we have to simplify, it becomes difficult. That process of simplification is very difficult. It's Virudh Dharma Ashay. That's why Srila Shukadeva Goswami, following the orders of Srimati Radharani, Shri Krishna. So Radha Krishna went back to their abode and Shuka, parrot, he stayed here. Now, when someone's beloved leaves, then for some days there is a very strong sense of separation. So that Shuka parrot is thinking, that where can I find Radha Krishna? Where I will find them? And if there is anything equivalent to them, should I go there? Then he thought, yes, the Lord said, Naham Vaisami Vaikunthe, Nacha Yogi Hridayam. I do not reside in Vaikuntham. I do not reside in the heart of yogis. Where do I reside? Where my pure devotees speak about my katha, I reside there. So Shukadeva Goswami understood. Now he started searching that where should I go, where should I find that pure devotee in whose Hari katha I can attain Lord. So he thought about Bhagavad Ji. It's not just that Shukadeva Goswami spoke Bhagavatam to Parikshit and before that there was no Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is eternal thing actually. Vedyam Vastavam Atra Vastu. The way Shri Krishna is Nitya, eternal, Shri Bhagavatji is also eternal. And Shukadeva Goswami, he knows the essence of Bhagavatam. And that's why in that Bhagavatam it has been described among the Vaishnavas, who is the best of all Vaishnavas? That is Vaishnava Nam Yatha Shambhu. Lord Shambhu, Shivji, he is the best of all Vaishnavas. Shukadevji is Param Bhagavat and his philosophy is full of Bhagavat. And he is Bhagavat Swarupa. Now, with this understanding that I can attain Shivji's association, he is the best of all Vaishnavas, he went to sit near Shivji and hear Bhagavatam, where Mahadev Shiva was speaking Bhagavat to his wife Parvati. What is his task? To destroy. Destruction is not his main task. And it has been said that, oh, to perform annihilation, destruction, Shivji has to perform Tandav. But no, such great personality, he does not need to dance just to destroy. If you just open his third eye, just by that, all the destruction happens. Just by opening the third eye. Such influential Devadidev Mahadev he is. Okay, why he performed Tandav? Do you know why? Krishna Naam, Ram Naam. And remembering the pastimes of Shri Radha Krishna, when he is not able to check his senses, control his senses, he stands up and starts dancing. He do a strong dance, like a very extreme, intense dance, like Mahaprabhu. Some places, people say that why can't you just sit and meditate and do Harikatha properly? Why do you dance and all, sing so much? You perform so many bhagavats, so many, many people, they come and say different things. What is this kirtan going on? Ladies are dancing, gents are dancing, this is a disco or what? Why can't you just sit and perform bhajan in a simple way? Why you are doing this external show off and all these dance and this and that? I said, okay, tell me who does not dance? He cross questioned that who dances? I said, have you heard about Miraji? Miraji was a great devotee. She danced in front of the Lord. Like Radhaji. He is saying, oh, Miraji like Radhaji? Said, no. How can Radhaji be compared with Miraji? They don't know anything. They just want to speak any rubbish. And if you go to Vrindavan, in the cassette, in the CD discs, there are so many different kind of songs that are generated these days. Oh, one is Radha, one is Meera, they both loved Krishna, this and that. There is no comparison. Where is Radhaji, where is Meera? Meera is Bhakt. She loves Krishna. But comparing Meera with Radhaji, this is completely nonsense. She got married, Meera, and the day when she got married, the same night, she is telling to her husband, can I tell you one thing? He said, yes. She said that before you, I had already married. The husband got so angry, why did you not tell me before? Meera said that, don't get angry, listen to me fully. She said, let me tell you, my first husband, I love him so much. You are my husband. I will do all my duties very nicely. But I cannot stop loving my first husband. Who is he? Meera ji, very pacifying pose, she said, Krishna. Then the husband became very much calm. Oh, you're talking about the Lord. Not about some other men. Oh, I love him so much. I stop myself. I try to control my emotions, but I cannot stop. So please don't stop me in future also. Radhaji, Maharaj, he said to Meera that you are the queen. So, please stay in the standards. Miraji said that I cannot follow standards because when I chant the holy name of Krishna, when I remember Shri Krishna, all my senses, they become out of control. And I just become, I don't have any external consciousness. Meera, she just cries and dances, Mere to Giridhar Gopal, Dusra na koi. Such a great queen, but even by the denial of the husband, she still performs such devotion. Now, because of this, the husband, the king, he thought that I will just kill this Meera. I will poison her. And we all know how he tried to poison. Meera ji at once drank that poison. Did anything happen? No. There are three such instances where poison had no effect. One instance in which poison was drunk, voluntarily. Second is forcefully, and third is by cheating. Meera ji was by cheating given this poison. The husband brought this charanamrit and said that please drink. Meera ji drank it, nothing happened. It's just 500, 400 years back, not a very old instance. One, he drank by his own desire, that is Mahadev ji. Nobody forced him. He drank and he became Nilkanth, the one with the blue throat. And Prahlad ji was forcefully made to drink the poison. Nothing happened to him as well. Why? Our Padmanabh Maharaj ji was speaking about this only. This is a shloka from Srimad Bhagavatam. The one who hear Bhagavat, speak Bhagavat, or even just appreciates the speakers and the Bhagavat, he becomes so strengthful. That all the whole world, even the whole world and the whole all demigods, demons, everyone get against him, still nothing happens to that personality. Why? Because they are Naam Nisht. Meera ji is Naam Nisht, Prahlad ji is Naam Nisht, Shiv ji is Naam Nisht. And this is the pastime of third canto, glories of Shiv ji. That personality whom the lust also cannot touch, he could actually just burn the Cupid just by opening his third eyes. That Cupid which makes the whole world dance on his fingers, Shivji performed the pastime of winning over this Cupid. How? Keeping his own wife on the lap, he is speaking Bhagavat in the assembly of rishis. The husband Shivji, he is speaking Bhagavat when the wife Parvati is embracing him and sitting on his lap, and he is speaking Bhagavat. He is showing that he is not touched by Cupid, not touched by lust, because his absorption is fully in Harinam, in Bhagavat Katha. If there is absorption, then only there is entrance. When absorption is there, then only the entrance is there. If absorption is not there, one cannot enter into anything. This is the glory of Shivji. And that's why Shukadeva Goswami, going near that Shivji, seeing that, oh, he is the real personality. He is the real person who is not even touched by lust. And he is Vaishnavanam Yathashambhu. He is the best of all Vaishnavas. On the other side, he indicated also that be cautious while hearing Hari Katha. Why? Because a Vaishnava Mukhod Girnam Putam Hari Kathamritam. Don't hear Hari Katha from any personality like this. Aise Vaise means anyone like this means. Those who are not Vaishnavas are called a Vaishnav. So don't hear from a Vaishnav. Non-Vaishnavas, no. Because if you will hear, what will happen? They are given an example. Like a bowl of milk, if touched by the mouth of a snake, then the milk looks like milk, which is very nourishing. But when touched by the mouth of the snake, it becomes poisonous. And if you drink it, then you will die. Understood? Milk is looking like milk, but because touched by the mouth of snake, it has become very poisonous. Now tell, poison is great or nectar is great? One side, it is said that Krishna Katha is like nectar. Tava Katha Amritam Tapta Jeevanam. Lord's Harikatha, Krishna Katha is like nectar. Evidence has been given by the gopis. On the other side, it has been said, so poison effect is more or nectar effect is more. If we say that poison's effect is more, then Krishna Katha's effect is less. The poison is more stronger than the nectar. No, nectar is important. Nectar is more glorious, superior. So how to reconcile this? Ravan, he abducted Sita Devi. Sita Devi is Swarup Shakti. In the same way, Bhagavat Katha also is Swarup Shakti. This is Nija Shakti of the Lord. But Ravan, he is not qualified to touch real Sita. Both demigods and demons, they cannot touch Sita Devi. So Ravan actually abducted the shadow Sita. The real Sita was hidden by Yogmaya. Understood? Second example. This is by demon Ravan. Shri Brahma Ji, he is the creator of the universe. He came in Braj and he abducted the sakhas of Krishna. Did he really abducted the real sakhas? No, Brahma Ji is not qualified to even touch them. So at that time, Yogmaya Ji created shadow sakhas. Mool sakhas, the real sakhas, they were hidden by Yogmaya. Because mool sakhas, they cannot be touched by Brahmaji. Neither demons, nor demigods, not even Brahmaji can touch. So both situations, Yogmayaji disappeared. In the same way, when a pure Vaishnav, like Shivji, like Gurudev, Guru Vargas, when they sing Krishna Katha, then that Krishna Katha becomes Krishna Tav Kathamritam. It becomes like nectar. When Shukadev Goswami describes that Katha, it's like Amrit, it's like nectar. And from that nectar, the whole Tribhuvan, the whole three worlds, they get auspicious. A Vaishnav like me, when he speaks Krishna Katha, then there is some poison. Now you will say, Katha is Katha, Katha is like Nirmal, Katha is so like nectar. But when a Vaishnava speaks, then Swarup Shakti gets covered and then comes the shadow Katha. It is not Katha, it's Vyatha. It's not the past times, it's actually just the words. Sri Jagadananda Pandit, he said in Prem Vivart, Asat Sangete Bhai Naam Kabu Nai. Sadhu Sangha. It said that one cannot chant in Asat Sangha. The biggest Asat Sangha, bad association, is no one else but my own mind. My own mind gives me a satsang, bad association. It pulls me towards attractions to others. It takes me towards bad activities, bad things, bad thoughts. Oh, I am chanting, but it's not really holy name. Just words are coming out. This is not holy name. बट आई वॉन्ट टू चैंट आई एम अ साधक ओ यदि करीब शुद्ध नाम इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू परफॉर्म प्योर डिवोशन शुद्ध नाम देन डू साधु संग देन यू विल गेट शुद्ध नाम देन यू विल गेट शुद्ध हरिकथा प्योर हरिकथा प्योर नाम एंड ऑल्सो देर इज वन अनदर थिंग That's added. Bhukti Mukti Vancha Dure Parihar. The desire to enjoy in this world, the desire of liberation just should be thrown very far. There should not be even a smell that comes inside our nose. Especially desire of liberation. If that desire keeps on walking with the holy name, then holy name will not come out. Only words will come out. In the same way, Harikatha. In the topics also, it's like that. Harikathas. So not like this. We have to be very selective. Shukdev Goswami is considering a lot and then he came to Shivji. Not thinking, oh, Shivji is very beautiful, very strong. He has, he's having trident. He is having moon on the head. He is having snake in the neck. Why he is accepted snake and this moon? Srila Bhaktivedanta Bharati Goswami Maharaj used to tell this thing. That once the moon god, he actually performed a fault. He became very lusty. He had 27 wives, beautiful wives. Still he became lusty and he did a wrong act. And because of which he got cursed to diminish. Every day he diminishes a little bit, little bit. So that moon also he wants to atone. Atonement. He tried to understand, he thought, to whom should I go and get the best of all atonements? He came to Shivji. He said, O Mahadev Baba, I am here for an atonement. I have got this curse that actually I did an offense. Shivji said, among all the atonements, the best one whichever fault you have done, offense you have done, just take shelter of holy name. Among all atonements, the best of all atonement is Hari Nam. Now who can say this? Only that personality who is completely faithful towards the holy name and who knows the glories of the holy name. He only can give that kind of instruction. Here Shivji's glories are also being reflected. That what kind of answer he is giving. Here Shivji's glories are also observed. Because there are different kinds of atonements. But atonement, taking shelter of holy name, it's the best of all atonement. Shri Chandra, considering the words of Shivji, he started taking shelter of Hari Nam, and just considering this, just observing this, that moon god, this Chandra, has actually given gravity to my words and accepted the shelter of holy name. I really want to keep this personality on my head because he has taken shelter of holy name. This is the symptom of Vaishnava, that oh, you have given importance to holy name, you are my master, let me keep you on my head. So many people come. Now, the people come that I am suffering this way, I am suffering that way. Now, different priests, they give different answer. Do this, do that. But see, the one who has faith in whichever direction, he will send you in that direction. Now, on Monday, what water you will add on Shivling, already so much rainfall is happening. Mahadev Baba is taking all the rain. So, he is not desiring for this water. What water he is desiring? See, Brahman takes water in the hand and takes Sankalpa. In Navdvip also, in Vrindavan also. A Brahman and a devotee. What's the difference? A Brahman, he takes oath taking water in the hand. And the devotee takes an oath taking tears in his hand. On his hand. So Shivji is desiring that water. We want that someone should come who does not say Bam Bam Bole or Oh Jai Mahadev. Someone should come who can sit near me and chant the glories of Radha Rani, who is my worshipable Munindra Vrinda Vandite. Radha Kripa Kataksh, if someone speaks, then I'll become very satisfied. My Swamini, my Radhaji, someone is speaking about my Krishna, I want to hear that. That's why, what was the atonement that he suggested? That is Naam. That's why he accepted him on his head. Because he is Prem. This Prem Swarupa. He is absorbed in that. He is giving atonement as the holy name. So now, Shivji is speaking Bhagavat Katha to Parvati and telling that you keep hearing and also keep indicating that you are hearing by saying It should not happen that I am just speaking and you are sleeping. So now, Mahadev Baba, he started Hari Katha. So Shivji is speaking, it's not ordinary. He knows the essence of Bhagavat and he says with a very pride. See, devotees also have a pride, and it's very important to have a pride. Devotees should also have. Not everywhere humility is fine. No. Humility is good in devotee association, but humility is not useful outside. Someone may say, oh, you are such a great, so you look like a devotee, you are becoming a devotee. As a materialist may say like this. So there you don't say that, oh, yeah, no, I am not a devotee, I am just trying. No, you say that, yes, I am a devotee of Krishna, I am disciple of my Guru Maharaj. I am so much having so much pride that I am connected to Gaudiya Math. I have this pride that whatever service I'll do to Radha Madhav, Radha Raman Vihari Ji. We have taken shelter of this mutt. I am connected to this mutt, to this philosophy. Whatever festival is there, I will come. If I want to donate anything, I will donate to Raman Vihari Ji. My attachment will go towards Raman Vihari Ji when I will give my attachments to him. If I serve them with my hand, if I clean the temple, if I distribute prasadam, that is one-pointedness. Otherwise what? In the morning went one direction, then second direction, no attachment to anyone. At the lotus feet of Sri Raman Vihari Ji, may we develop some one-pointed attachment. For that we are trying. What I was speaking? Shukadev Goswami. So Shivji is asking, please just say in between. Because Shivji knows, Aham Vedmi, Shuk Vedmi, Vyas Vedmi Navetcha. Shivji, with a very true ego, he is saying. What he is saying? I know the essence of Bhagavat. Shukadev Goswami knows the essence of Bhagavat. Vyasji knows or does not know, I am not sure. Maybe he knows, maybe he does not know. I cannot give a stamp in this. Shivji is saying this, Aham Vedmi. I know the essence of Bhagavat. Shivji knows the essence. He is speaking Bhagavat Katha to whom? To his wife. And the wife is saying, Now in Bhagavad Ji there is this instance, Shukadev Parikshit Samvad, Shaunak Shud Samvad, these conversations, Vidur Maitre Samvad, right? So Vyasji, he wrote Bhagavad Ji when? He wrote his own name in that. Our Guru Vargas, Shishimad Bhakti, Vedant Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj is saying this thing, that when all these conversations happened, Shukadev Parikshit, Shaunak Shud, विदुर मैत्रे आफ्टर दैट वेद व्यास जी रोट श्रीमद भागवतम एंड हाउ ही रोट ही टोल्ड गणेश जी यू गिव द डिक्टेशन आई विल डिक्टेट एंड यू राइट गणेश जी सर ओके बट देयर इज अ डील यू विल नॉट स्टॉप इफ यू स्टॉप देन माय पेन विल स्टॉप एंड After that, I'll not write. So you just keep on saying and I'll keep on writing. So Vyas ji said that, okay, I then also have a deal, condition. You will write everything after understanding. You will not just write without understanding anything. If you don't understand something, then you have to stop and think or ask from me. So Vyas ji is speaking. And then he in between added such a point, such words that Ganesh ji got perplexed that, I cannot write. I have to understand this first, what he has said. So he chose Ganesh ji to write. Why? Because he is the destroyer of all inauspiciousness. No. Why Ganesh ji, he is having such potency. Try to go inside that. Why we worship Ganesh ji? Why everyone worship Ganesh ji? Just because he is the destroyer of inauspiciousness? No. Try to understand the reason. Ganesh ji is the son of whom? Of Shivji. Shivji day and night what he do? With five mouth he is chanting Ram Naam. Brahma ji has four mouth face and Shivji has five. And with five mouth on the beads of Rudraksh she chants Ram Ram Ram. Now this also is a problem in the flight in the society. I get so many people in the flight who argue. They say, oh, we should have a relaxed mind, a good mind. Why to show off on by chanting on beads? I just do it in my mind. So I said, really? Is it really a show off by chanting on mala? So my worshipable Lord is Mahadev. My worshipable Lord is Mahadev. I don't chant on beads. I just caught the link. I asked that, oh, do you know Mahadev chants on which beads? On Rudraksh. Oh, yes, I know. I said, oh, is his mind not peaceful? His mind is not pure? He could also have chanted without beads. And he's sitting in Kailash, in that mountain, in the peak. So whom he is showing off there? He could have chanted by his own mind. Why he is taking Rudraksh beads in his hands? Oh yeah, he must be doing, I don't know. I cannot give an answer. So when Shivji, such great personality, when he is chanting on the beads, and he is showing us, it is Vaishnav Naam Yatha Shambhu.
जो वस्तु निर्देशात्मक श्लोक है तीन मंगलाचरण होते हैं नमस्कारात्मक आशीर्वादात्मक
सो देयर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ मंगलाचरण नमस्कारात्मक वस्तु निर्देशात्मक नमस्कारात्मक मीन्स दैट मंगलाचरण वेयर वन पेज ऑबिसेंसेस टू वंस वर्शिपेबल आशीर्वादक मीन्स One desires for blessings of oneself, for oneself and the hearers. And there is Vastu Nirdeshatmak Mangalacharan, in which there is description of what will be the topic of this. So first shlok is Vastu Nirdeshatmak of Bhagavad. That's the seed from which the whole desire fulfilling tree appeared. Someone is sleeping. Please everyone say Radhe Radhe. Jai. Janma dasya yata anvya charth tris charthishva bhikyaswara tene brahm mehrade adi kavya muyanti yat surya tejo vare mridam yata vinimayo yat arti salti mishar gumishar dham na shvena sadani rastu kuhukam satyam param dhimahi
Janma dasya
Guruji used to say that this shlok can be explained with understanding through Krishna, Radhaji, and connecting with Mahaprabhu also, and Gurudev also, and Radhashmi just happened. Janma dasyata. Janma means, see, Bhagavad Ji started with Janma. Bhagavad Ji is a festival. The Ajanma, the one who is beyond, then what's the point of Shringar Ras? Srimati Radharani is the source of Krishna's love, Madhur Ras, Shringar Ras. Where? Sadharani Rati, Kubja also have love for Krishna. Mathuras, Maheshya, Rania, the queens, they also love Krishna. And the gopis of Vraj, they also love Krishna. But the love of all these three, there is so much difference. Those who are called as Sadharani Rati, who? Kubja of Mathura. Why she is Sadharani Rati? Because somewhere or other, there is Atmendriya Priti Vancha. She loves Krishna, but Shukdev Goswami is telling in Bhagavad, in an indicating way, she is attacking Kubja. He said that she attained Krishna, but still there was Sadharani Rati. I will love Krishna so that I'll get satisfied. This is Atmendriya Priti Vancha. That is Sadharani Rati. Ordinary love. Dwarika queens, they have Madhur Ras, Shringar Ras. But in that love, what's the mood? They will worship, serve Krishna so that he will also be satisfied and I'll also be satisfied. So there is a tinge, there is a portion that I'll also be satisfied. So even if there is a little portion that I'll also get satisfied, then it is Atmendriya Priti Vancha. Why? Because here there is desire of one's own happiness. So that is Atmendriya. So that is Samanjasya Rati. But when we talk about gopis, and the gopis, there is not even among all the gopis, Radha Ji is the topmost who does not have even a smell of lust. There is no tendency for selfish enjoyment. Radha Ji do everything for Krishna's happiness. Mata Ji, they wear earrings, tops and the ears. These are for as ornaments. But Radha Ji's ornament is Krishna Katha on the ear. On the nose, she has Gajagupta. The nose ring also is there. That nose ring, what it is? It's the smell of Krishna's body. The fragrance of Krishna's body. Smelling that, that's her ornament. Krishna Naam's holy name, chanting all the time, that's the redness of Radhaji's lips. Radha Ji, she takes bath 3 times. देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ बाथ, करुणामृत, लवनामृत एंड तरुणामृत. शी टेक्स बाथ इन द नेक्टर ऑफ करुणा, कंपैशन.
माधुर्य रस की जो वर्षा होती है, देखो वर्षा तो ऊपर से नीचे ही आएगी, नीचे से ऊपर तो जाएगी.
ऑल द रेनफॉल ऑफ माधुर्य रस, सी इट हैपेंस फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम. अवर पद्मनाभ महाराज जी से वेंट टू हैव दर्शन ऑफ बरसाना, देयर इज सो मच रेनफॉल, द वाटर इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द माउंटेन लाइक अ रिवर, टचिंग द लोटस फीट ऑफ राधा जी. Came out, came down, and the whole farm they got drowned. So the source of Madhurya Ras is Samartha, is from Samartha Rati only. This is the source of Madhurya Ras, of Shringar Ras, whose birth is just from Shri Radha Ji. Madhurya Ras cannot take birth from Sadharani Rati. Not by the queens of Dwarka, because there is some portion of lust. But Radha Ji, who is the source of Samartha Rati, she does not have even the smell of lust. That's why it has been said. Oh Shyam Sundar, if you come happily in front of us and gives us bliss, or if you do not come in front of us, you stay away from us, drown us in the pool of separation, in any situation, you will always stay my Pranath. My love will not get subdued. Because the definition of prem is this. What is love? Sada dhvans rahitam. That thing which does not get broken, which does not get destroyed, even when there are so many reasons of destruction of that love. That is the source of Madhurya Ras. That is Sri Radha Ji. No one else. चंद्रावली एंड राधा जी,
लेकिन फिर दोनों में क्या अंतर आ गया? अंतर है.
व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू?
एक मदिया भाव,
वन इज ततिया भाव, वन इज मदिया भाव, वन इज मधु स्नेह, अनदर इज कृत स्नेह. दिस इज होल उज्ज्वल नीलमणि.
समझ आ रहा है भाई?
या आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग?
समझ आ रहा है? किस-किस को समझ आ रहा है बताना? क्या करूं मैं?
Once I was with Pujapa Tirth Maharaj in Jammu. All new devotees. All new. Like only 10 devotees and 500 people were new. And I was sitting with Tirth Maharaj and he was speaking, Ujjwal Nilmadi. I said, Maharaj, he said, what happened? I said, Maharaj, please come little down. Tirth Maharaj said, oh, just shut up. I have just taken a high fly, I'll not come down now. There's so much relishment, so much taste is there. The understanding of Goswami Varga is so much relishing. See, don't think that I am saying this. The way Sri Guruji, he used to sing this katha. Doing Anukirtan and remembering his lotus feet, I am saying this. Everything is going at the lotus feet of Srila Gurudev. Otherwise, what we would know, what we had known, no, we were like foolish. We were like roaming in the streets. But what they say in simple language? Catching a worm from the drain, from a very bad, dirty place. Nobody takes garbage. But our Gurudev, he took garbage. He lifted that garbage. He cleaned and he gave qualification to everyone. Everyone is qualified. Brahmachari, sannyasi, grahastha, vanaprasthi, my daughters, everyone are qualified. Of what? Of this wealth of Srila Rupa Goswami. I am making everyone qualified. Just distribute this. This is the moods of Srila Gurudev. Bujive rasik jan. Na bujive mood. Rasik will understand and relish it. And everyone else will try to relish. Among Chandravali and Radha ji also, what's the difference? Tadiya bhav and madhiya bhav. In the moods of Chandravali, Krishna, I am yours. And Radha ji's moods, you are mine, Krishna. It's same thing? No. One is saying, I am yours. There is Dakshin moon. And Radha ji, Bhamya Bhav. Oh, Krishna, you are mine. I have full right on you. With full right, she is saying, you are mine. Then second example, Sri Rupa Goswami gave the example of ghee and honey. Ghee, while eating, how it tastes? Today, everyone will get one big spoon of ghee. Will you be able to eat? No, yuck. Oh, if you just cook with ghee, then it is very nice, very tasty. So we have to add something and then ghee will be tasteful. But nobody eats ghee like this. So Chandraval is like ghee. And Radhaji is like honey. Honey. We don't have to add anything in the honey. Do anyone add sugar in honey? You can just have honey directly. It's so sweet, so nice. So Radhaji also like this.
Rani lage maharani lage mano karo karo jandari ko rani lage. Main jaan gaya sir, wo prasang aaya to bataya. Abhi bhajan hi sunte katha pe thoda sa Krishna bhi
dekhte. Let's take a break. We'll hear bhajan.
Sri Radha
पाओ किशोरी तेरे
या आपके चरणों की रज करानी है राधा जी।
चरण की रज करानी बैठी रहूं जल के कोने हो बैठी जन के कोने श्याम राधे का किशोरी दे
क्या बोल रहा है
चरण की रज पाए
सभी को समझ आ रहा है ठीक है पीछे भी दोहराइएगा
चरण की रज पाओ किशोरी तेरे चरण की रज पाओ चरण की रज पाओ किशोरी तेरे चरण की Yeah.
ब्रज की हम प्रार्थना करने वाले हैं और उस ब्रज के लिए कौन कौन तरसते हैं ध्यान से सुनो।
यार जी मेरे हम आज
जो बरसाने से जो पर्वत है वो कौन है? साक्षात ब्रह्मा जी है। कभी तो लाल की पीड़ा से बढ़ रही और उनकी सखियां उनके छत्र की रज बढ़ेगी। ये महिमा है राधा रानी की बच्चे कह रहे हैं
Hey, Radha.
के लिए दोनों हाथ उठाकर और जिसको नृत्य करना है वो भी मिले केवल 5 मिनट के लिए।
हरे कृष्णा
हरे कृष्णा
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
कोई कथा सुनेगा? नहीं, सबका नाच लेगा वो, बस इसी बात की संतुष्टि है मैं। एक तो बाहर वर्षा हो रही है, भीतर वर्षा हो रही है, भीगना तो है या सोच लो कहाँ भीगना है, कहाँ भीगना है, चलो भीगो फिर। छाता तो नहीं लिया है? ऐसी रात अष्टमी हुई, लहर चल रही है अभी तक।
जन्मादस्ययतः आद्य रस श्रृंगार रस मधुर रस, जिसमें इन विच देर इज कुंज लीला निकुंज लीला एंड श्री कृष्णास रास लीला,
ये मधुर रस का प्रतीक,
दिस इज द साइन ऑफ मधुर रस।
इन लीलाओं में यदि राधा जी ना हो,
इन दिस पास्ट टाइम्स इफ राधा जी इज नॉट देयर, And what Kunjalila? Radhaji's name is Kunjeshwari, who is the goddess of Kunja. And she is the goddess of Kunja. That's why Krishna's name is Kunja Bihari. If Radhaji is not there, with whom Krishna will sit in Kunja? He will sit alone. He will come doing Shringar alone. No. Everything you do for Radhaji's service. Radhaji's name is Raseshwari. She is the mistress of Ras. If she is not there, then how Krishna's name become Raseshwar? It's impossible.
Radhaji ke karan Ras, aur Ras ke karan Krishna ka naam Raseshwar.
Because of Radhaji is Ras, and because of Ras, Krishna's name is Raseshwar. Krishna is saying this, O Radhaji, if you are not here, what is the use of Ras? There is no Ras without you. Ras bhang hoy lo Radha bihan. Our Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying this. Radhaji, if she leaves Ras, if Radha ji, she leaves Ras, then there is no point of serving Radha ji, of serving Krishna also. So, Janma Dasayataha, because Jhulan Leela, the swinging pastimes. If Radhaji is not there, then with whom Krishna will sit on the swing? There is no point. So that's why Sakhis are praying. O Radhe Jhulan Padharo Jhuk Aaye Badra.
Jhuk Aaye Badra Dhire Aaye Badra O Shama Jhulan
Padharo Jhuk Aaye Badra.
Radhaji is showing sulky mood. Krishna never shows sulkiness. Radhaji shows. Jhulan would also, swinging pastime will not happen without Radhaji. And if Jhulan not there, then what's the use of, what's the bliss of Holi?
Holy Rasiya,
Neither holy,
yeah.
Nor Julan,
or nor Ras,
and nor Ras.
इन समस्त लीलाओं का उद्गम स्थान क्या है, इसका जन्म स्थान क्या है? एकमात्र राधा
जी. नो कुंज लीला निकुंज लीला नथिंग. द सोर्स ऑफ ऑल दिस इज राधा जी.
गोलोक से इस पृथ्वी पर आने का प्रयोजन एकमात्र राधा जी. बस यही
राधा जी इज द मेन कॉज ऑफ हिम कमिंग फ्रॉम
इसने जन्म से
गोलोक टू ब्रज टू हियर ऑन अर्थ.
ये उद्गम स्थान
है. सो इट्स द सोर्स.
यदि राधा जी ना हो,
इफ राधा जी इज नॉट देयर,
तो कृष्ण कैसे सीखेंगे कि प्रेम,
देन हाउ कृष्णा विल लर्न हाउ टू लव.
इन्हीं से सीखकर प्रेम की शिक्षा लेकर सबको प्रेम बांटते हैं.
लर्निंग फ्रॉम हर ही डिस्ट्रीब्यूट्स लव टू एवरीवन.
सबको प्रेम बांटते हैं. इन्हीं से प्रेम की शिक्षा लेकर राधा जी से शिक्षा लेकर ही नित्य कौशल को सीखते हैं. राधा जी इनके कौन है? गुरु हैं.
लर्न्स एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम राधा जी. राधा जी इज द वन हु इज गुरु ऑफ कृष्णा.
एक बार
डांसिंग टीचर
राधा जी ने वृंदा सखी से पूछा.
Once राधा जी आस्ट वृंदा सखी
कुंडम रण्यम किमं कुरुते नित्य शिक्ष गुरु का. ये वृंदे कहां से आ रही हो? बोलते हरि के पास से, कृष्ण के पास से. कहां है? बोलते कुंडम रण्यम, राधा कुंड पर है. क्या कर रहे हैं? बोलते
राधा जी आस्ट वृंदा देवी, फ्रॉम वेयर आर यू कमिंग?
नित्य शिक्ष गुरु का.
Said, I'm coming from Radha Kund. I saw Krishna there. What he is doing? He is learning Krishna, learning dance. Radha ji asked, who is that personality who is teaching Krishna dance? So Vrinda Devi is saying, Radha ji, when you dance in on Radha Kund,
उन पताओं को देखते हैं और उसी भाव भंगिमा में नृत्य सीखते हैं और नाम.
So when राधा जी dances on राधा कुंड, the branches and the trees, creepers and all, they take the impressions of राधा जी, and seeing those impressions, कृष्णा learn dance.
तो नृत्य की शिक्षा राधा जी से, वेणु वादन की शिक्षा राधा जी से, गान करने की शिक्षा राधा जी से,
सही,
और सबसे श्रेष्ठ प्रेम करने की शिक्षा.
Get all the teachings from Radha. How to sing, how to play flute, how to dance, how to love. Everywhere he just glorifies himself, I am the best. But in front of Radha ji, he raises his hand. Na jaane Radha prem aache koto bal.
Na jaane Radha ji ke prem mein kitna.
I don't know how much love is there in Radha ji. And with folded hands, he also accepts Radhika Prem Guru Ame Shishan. Radha ji is the guru of my prem.
In
all this Madhur Ras, Shringar Ras, the source of this pastime is only Radha ji. If Radha ji is not there, then the pastime of Dan Keli happened on Dan Ghati. How it will be possible in Barsana, in Sakri Khur? The pastime of taking tax, from where it will happen? All these pastimes in Bhandir, Radha ji is the source. How? Janma dasyata Anvya vitirek, Anvya and vitirek,
direct
and indirect.
Anvya vitirek ka matlab, milan aur virek. संभोग लीला
सेपरेशन एंड मीटिंग
मिलन लीला और विरह लीला ये दोनों नाम हो तो प्रेम का उत्कर्ष ना हो
if both separation and meeting is not there then love would not reach its pinnacle Guruji used to say two sides of love separation and meeting if only separation no meeting if only meeting no separation then there will be no full bliss that's why our Rupa Goswami has said that without vipralambha bhav there is no point of enjoying meeting so anvya gatirek
dono bhav se
with these two moods
sheshata aur pradhanata
with these two sides radha ji
samast leelaon mein sab shesht jo leela hai
superiority and importance The best of all pastime is Ras Leela, regarding which Shri Krishna says,
Santi
Yatya
Yatya.
Although I perform many pastimes, but when I remember Ras Leela, I just get completely mesmerized.
ये वो रास लीला है शारदीय रास कहो या वसंती रास कहो
दिस इज दैट रास लीला बीट शारदीय रास और वसंती रास
ये लीला करने का प्रयोजन
दिस द पर्पस ऑफ दिस पास्ट टाइम
राधा जी की आराधना करना है
इज टू वर्शिप राधा जी
ये दिखलाना
ये शो दिस दैट
अनवे व्यतिरे
Anvya Vyatirek, meeting and separation in both the sides, Radha Ji is superior. How? Let's understand. In Shardiya Ras,
see,
our this Bhagavat Katha after Radha Ashtami,
so
there is a wave which is going on. One is of Radha Ji. And his recipient of mercy, Shukadev Goswami. Because these 7 days, those 7 days where Shukadev Goswami spoke Bhagavad, so without glorifying him, how can we understand Bhagavad? So that Shukadev Goswami, in Ras Leela, he is saying,
तत्त्व गत्वं वनम देशम दीप्तकेशम आप्रवेत ना पारेहं चलितुं नय माम यत्र ते प्रिया एवं उक्तम प्रिया अहस्कल उरायते इति ततच अंतर्दय कृष्णा सवदु अनवतम नहीं शुकदेव गोस्वामी जी के वचन है उन्हीं की वंदना कर रहे हैं यदि साच मैंने तरात्मा वरिष्ठम सर्वयोषितम सारी गोपियों को छोड़कर
लिविंग ऑल गोपीज जस्ट टू राधा जी विद हिमसेल्फ होम श्री कृष्ण ओनली राधा जी
सारी गोपियों को छोड़ दिया
लेफ्ट ऑल द गोपीज
शतकोटि गोपी
शतकोटि गोपी
100 करोड़ सुंदर सुंदर लक्ष्मी स्वरूप
100 करोड़ ब्यूटीफुल ब्यूटीफुल लक्ष्मी स्वरूप गोपीज
बट
They could not satisfy Krishna. And just took Radha Ji with himself. So just think about this, how Radha Ji is so glorious. What are her qualities? Who is great? Among Who is the most superior among all gopis? That is Radha Ji. Second, in separation,
Anve
and Vyatirek. When Krishna he disappeared among gopis. Do you know what gopis are doing? Oh, where is Krishna? Where Krishna has gone? Where Krishna has gone? Krishna is not seen. And to get over that separation, that suffering of separation, they started acting Krishna's pastime. All the gopis, they are imitating Krishna's pastime, Putana, Shaktasur, Govardhan Leela, all these Leela. But among them also, who became Putana? As soon as Krishna killed Putana, two gopis, they together, they are doing, imitating the pastime. But the question is, who became Putana, who became Krishna? There is a requirement of two. So Yudheshwari, the leader of the gopis, they became Krishna. And the servants of these leader group leaders, they become Putana. Because that servant's service is to serve the leader, group leaders. Group leaders want to relish rasa, becoming Krishna. And their servant, mid-servants are becoming Shaktasur Putana and satisfying their group leaders. But where they remember Krishna's Bhakt Vatsal quality, then they remembered about Damodar Leela, Dam Bandhan Leela. But as soon as this remembrance came, the question arises that Krishna is there and Yashoda is there. Who will become Yashoda? Who will become Krishna? So who will become Yashoda? Why? Because can a wife take the form of a mother? It's so different, mother's mood and wife's mood. The gopis are thinking that Yashoda Maya caught Krishna. So gopis became Krishna, but which gopi will become Yashoda? Can any gopi bring Mata Bhav? No. Everyone started thinking. So now in their remembrance, this pastime came and they want to perform. Now to harmonize all this pastime, Paurnamasi ji came and she became Yashoda ji. Where there is requirement of any harmonization, so Yogmaya comes. Who is this Yogmaya? Radhesh Keli. So this is Purnamasi ji who reconciles all pastimes. And then only this imitating pastime could happen. So gopis, they are imitating Krishna's pastime. On the other side, what's happening? Krishna is serving Radhaji. How? He is setting the hair of Radharani. He is massaging the lotus feet of Radharani.
Now, when Krishna is serving Radha ji,
Radha ji is thinking that my gopis should come at once and relish this pastime of how Krishna is getting controlled by me. He is hypnotized by me. So Radha ji, she is satisfying Krishna, plus she wants to satisfy the gopis also. And she knows that all the gopis will be very satisfied seeing that how Krishna is being favorable to me, he is serving me. Understood? That's why Radha ji said,
Na
paare hum chalitum.
Radha ji ke bhav mein vibhavit hokar aur tadatmya ko prapt hokar ye baat ko kehte hain. He Shyam Sundar, main chal nahi paungi.
Radha ji is saying,
pata hai,
oh Shyam Sundar, I cannot walk. She knows that if I say I cannot walk, then Krishna will massage my feet or lift me up on his shoulder. And at that time, gopis will come and they'll be very happy seeing this. See, Radha ji is with Krishna. There is a reciprocation of love, but Radha ji is, she is thinking about Braj gopis. So she is not selfish. She will enjoy Krishna only herself. No, she does not have such moods. She is thinking about Vraj Gopis who are my Kaya Vyuha, my expansions, because these Vraj Gopis together, they arrange for my and Krishna's meeting. Jai Jai Radha Krishna Yuga Lamila. Gopis desire to arrange meeting of Radha and Krishna. So Radha ji will go taking Krishna herself? No. And she will enjoy? No. She will serve the pastimes. Always remember this point. Gopi gand nahi kaam gand. They don't have even the smell of their own selfish lust. So Radha ji is thinking, my gopis should come and they should know how Krishna is controlled by me and serving me. And that time Shyam Sundar also saw, gopis are coming. Shyam Sundar is thinking that if gopis will come and see this, they may become jealous of Radha ji, thinking that Radha ji all together were there in Ras, but you are so selfish, you took Krishna alone. Krishna is thinking, I actually brought Radha ji, Radha ji didn't go. So all this fault should come on my head, this fault should not come on Radha ji. I should be called as a faulty and a cheater. So that's why Krishna left, disappeared, and Radha ji is crying in separation.
Kwasi kwasi mahabhuja dasyaste karpanne me sakye darsham se nidhi. He mere naath, he mere priyatam, he raman preshta, aap kahan gaye, kahan gaye, main aapki dasi hoon.
Oh naath, oh raman preshta, where are you, where have you gone? I am your maid servant, I am here waiting, please come, come give your darshan. At that time all the gopis, they came and they saw.
Radha ji baithkar vilap kariye us nishtur ne.
Radha ji is doing vilap. Radha ji is suffering. And that heartless Krishna, he left Radha ji also and let her suffer in the separation. And together, in one tone, they said one thing. Vipaksha, Swapaksha, all of them. They said in one tone. That what Shukdev Goswami is saying. Anya Radha Tonunam Bhagavan Hari Vishwa Yanno Vihaya. Now Shukdev Goswami could not control, check himself. Seeing the state of Radha ji, although he took the vow, I will never take the name of Radha ji. But he could not stop himself and he said, this gopi is that which worshipped by Krishna the most. That's why her name is Radha. This is Anvyavatirekha. glories of Radha ji in meeting also and in separation also, superiority of Radha ji. Gopis are saying that we are imitating the pastimes of Krishna, but Radha ji is not having that potency also. She is not that strength that she can imitate. She is just sitting and crying. Now this is the purpose of Ras, to show the superiority of Radha ji. And another ras is Vasant ras. In that Radha ji would leave ras, and Krishna searching for Radha ji and then sitting. That Madhav, that Krishna also sitting, he is crying out, Radhe, 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 Virahe. That means, who is superior in Vasantras? Radha ji. In Shardaras, in meeting and separation, Radha ji. Meeting in separation and separation in meeting. Meeting in separation. Separation in me. Where? In Nandgaon. Who all of you been there? In Nandgaon there is Prem Sarovar. Radha ji is with Krishna. And at that time, a bumblebee came, making some sound. He saw the lotus feet of Radha ji and said that, oh, this is bumblebee, and bumblebee sits on flowers. Now touching the lotus feet of Radha ji, Krishna Sakha Madhu Mangal, he took that stick and started chasing, showing away this bumblebee. And then after that he said, oh, the Madhusudan is gone, he said. So the bumblebee's one name is Madhusudan, means the one who extracts the honey, extract nectar from the flowers. So Madhusudan is gone. And Krishna's one name is Madhusudan. Radha ji is with Krishna, such strong meeting. But just by listening this, that Madhusudan, that is Krishna, has gone, Radha ji developed such strong separation. And calling out, Krishna, 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 she is running everywhere. Where is Krishna? Where has Krishna? Kothai Krishna? Seeing the rain clouds, she remembers Krishna. Seeing peacock, she remembers Krishna. She sees the mahal tree, she remembers Krishna. So one day Radha ji says to Lalita ji, Lalita, if Krishna does not have compassion towards me and leaves me, then I will give up my life in his separation. But Lalita, just be merciful on me. Do one thing. When I will leave my body, then just take one tamal tree and make my body embrace that tamal tree. Then just bind me with that. Why? Because after leaving my body, I want to embrace Krishna only. And tamal tree is like semblance, it's like a signifies Krishna only. So in that, this meeting, in that separation in meeting, and that became the reason that Krishna left Braj and went to Dwarka. All that demon killing pastime, marriages and all these things, the purpose was all these secondary. The primary purpose was this pastime in Prem Sarovar. to actually give the bliss of separation to Radha ji. What is this? Separation means crying. So crying is also tasteful. Yes. Some people drink tea. Some drink soup. If it is cold, then it doesn't taste good. So the more hot it is, we like it more. Vireh also, the separation also is like this. Hot, hot. And just sipping it one by one. So this is compared with Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is comparing it with the sugar cane juice. Ehi prema swadan tapt ikshu charnam mukhe jwala nahi tyajan.
बताइए वीरे का आस्वादन कैसा है, जैसे गन्ने को रस निकालते हैं ना, उसको उबालते हैं उस रस को.
लाइक व्हेन दे एक्सट्रैक्ट शुगर केन जूस एंड देन बॉइल इट. नाउ द बॉइलिंग जूस इट बिकम्स जागरी.
गरम गरम पीने में बड़ा स्वाद लगता है.
नाउ ड्रिंकिंग दैट हॉट इट्स वेरी टेस्टफुल. द टंग इज बर्निंग बट इट्स स्टिल वेरी टेस्टफुल. मुखे ज्वलन ना है तेजन. द माउथ इज बर्निंग बट वी डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू लीव इट. सच टेस्टफुल. सो हॉट एंड टेस्टी. शुगर केन जूस बॉइलिंग दैट लिक्विड. In the same way, viraha ras is very tasteful. In this world, separation is painful. If someone gets separated from us, it's very painful. But this is replica, this is a reflection of that spiritual world. In that spiritual world, that separation becomes very blissful. And to give that bliss to Radha ji, Shri Krishna, in the pastimes of Prem Sarovar, when he showed, when he saw this, then he desired that I want to serve Radhaji fully, so I will just go away. And in behind me, Radhaji will day and night think about me, call my name, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. And what will happen? She will relish my separation. That's why janma dasyataha. The source of that meeting and separation is just to give bliss to Radhaji. And for that, so much pastimes he performed. So many demon killing, this and that, marriages. So many things he did just with one purpose. Only one purpose. What's that purpose? To give bliss to Radhaji. Staying far and still giving that bliss. How? It's bliss of separation. Separation in meeting. And then meeting in separation. When Radha ji comes to such level of separation, then in that separation she attains the complete embrace of Krishna. That's why direct and indirect. So this meeting and separation also are of three kinds. Is it too much? Bhavi viraha, bhuta viraha, bhavan viraha.
Aise hi bhavi milan, bhut milan, bhavan milan.
Bhavi milan, bhuta milan and bhavan milan.
Kyunki bahar to ja nahi paoge.
Sorry.
Abhi bolta hu itni tez barish aayegi. Isse se andar hi bheeg jao. Yahan to ho rahi hai sir. भावी विरह तीन प्रकार विरह की दशा बताई किसने? हमारे श्री गोस्वामी ने.
श्री रूप गोस्वामी से थ्री स्टेट्स.
गोपियों ने बस इतना सुना
भावी मिलन
कृष्ण
gopis just heard that Akrur has come and he will take Krishna Balaram. Akrur has come and take Krishna Balaram. So this is just anticipation that already they got to know that Krishna will leave. So this is lowest viraha separation. Second separation is that Krishna has left and went to Mathura. And behind, what's the state?
मन रो लागे ना सखीरी में रो शाम बिना मन रो लागे ना ओ मन रो लागे ना सखीरी में रो शाम बिना मन रो लागे ना ओ शाम बिना
श्याम बिना मन रो लागे ना हो श्याम बिना श्याम बिना मन रो लागे ना सखीरी मेरो श्याम बिना मन रो लागे
Now together all the gopis, they are sitting and discussing that we should chastise, we should complain about Shyam. We should go to his mother and complain about him. So crying, they are saying,
बहुत सतावे
चलो चले यशोदा धाम
सखी रे बहुत सतावे श्याम सखी रे बहुत सतावे
We don't have time to sing, but it's a very beautiful bhajan. Maya se kahenge, tera gopala, tera kanha, kapate jhaliya man ka kala. Isse dukhi, braj gwal ki bala, gokul ka hai badnaam. Chalo chale, Yashoda dham. Very beautiful moods. Shant Maharaj ji brought Aarti paraphernalia, so I just understood the sign. So it's like a very nice strategy to like indicate that time is over. Previously when guests used to come in the house, so Atithi means we don't know the date, like time when he will come. He can come anytime. Now the guests, they don't go. In the house, we need privacy, we want to talk, cannot talk in front of the guest. Now, how to actually make him go? So, let's first start throwing utensils in the kitchen. So, this is like an indication that you need to go now. If he does not, understanding, thinking that, oh, it's okay, some utensils are just falling. So, the guest is not leaving for 10-15 days. Now, started asking, oh, is everything all right in your house, in your family? Now, the host, they say, oh, everything is fine, everything is fine. Now, the host are very much in difficult situation, how to throw, how to like make him go. So now, they decided that let's just put salt 4 times more, put chilies 4 times more, so that he starts crying while eating and then he will just go. So, I just understood the sign from Maharaji also. It's 9 p.m. So, please finish it. But I am also very like stubborn. Whatsoever utensils he is throwing, but he is performing aarti or anything, I am not going to leave before 12 in the midnight. All glories to Radha Rani. Anyway, I'm just saying like this. There are 3 types of state of viraha. Bhavi viraha. And then that state that Shyam Sundar has left, and behind these gopis are singing. The cows are not eating grass. The birds are not singing. So this is the state of Braj. When Guruji used to sing this katha, he used to start crying, used to keep weeping. He used to just get immersed in those moods. And Guruji used to describe these pastimes. So this is one state of viraha. And then there is third stage of viraha. That is the superior, most superior. And that is when Krishna and Balram, they are sitting on this chariot of Akrur, and Braj gopis are holding the reins of the chariot, that we will not let you go. If you want to go, then just go over our bodies. Ride this chariot over our bodies. Oh Akrur, you are not Akrur, you are Krur, you are cruel. You are taking away our life in front of us. So this state, this particular instance, when the Pranath is going in front of your eyes, that is the highest state of separation. So like three types of separation, in the same way, three types of Milan, meeting. Now the bell will ring, so that's why I just spoke in brief. One Milan is Bhavi Milan. Krishna is in Kunj, Radha Ji is in Kunj. And she's just hoping that Krishna is gonna come now. He's gonna come now. So this is Bhavi Milan. She is hoping. And then second is, Krishna has come to Kunja. Krishna has already arrived in Kunja. And Radhaji and Krishna both, they are embracing each other. Completely embracing. This is also not full Milan. Now there is another stage of Milan in which Krishna entered into the heart of Radhaji. In the heart of Radhaji, there is this wealth which she does not show to anyone. See, the sadhus, they don't show that how much Harinam I do, how much pranams I do. So the love that is present in the heart of Radhaji, who is not available to anyone, no gopi has it. Krishna himself does not have it. So she keeps that wealth locked in her heart, because if that wealth is gonna canvas is coming out in front of everyone, then everyone will glorify Radhaji only. But Radhaji does not want her glories. She wants Krishna's glories everywhere, and that's why she has locked her real moods inside her heart, so that no one can actually come. And that is Madanakhya Mahabhav. Sne prane rag anurag modan madan Madanakhya Mahabhav. That is only just in the heart of Radhaji, no one else. And Krishna, he wants this only, that I enter into that cave of in that heart cave and just bring out that wealth and show in front of the whole world that the best of all, the most superior, the one who is worshipable to me also, that is Srimati Radhika. And Radhika does not want this. That's why she has actually closed tightly in her heart, and she does not show these things. So the both Krishna and Radhika, they are having this competition. Radhaji does not want to show, and Krishna wants to bring that wealth out and show in front of everyone in the world. So this is the third stage of meeting, where Krishna is entering into the heart of Radhaji. So what's so glorious? When Krishna can enter into the womb of Uttara. So why can Krishna not enter the heart of Radhaji? Krishna can go to save Parikshit in the womb of Uttara. So what's the problem in going into the heart of Radhaji? Who is present in the heart of Radhaji? Krishna wants to reach that wealth. And to reach that wealth, he had to take shelter of Radhaji. And as soon as
he
entered into the cave of Radhaji's heart and touched that wealth, if the thief touches the wealth, then his complexion changes. Because the reaction comes. Shyam Sundar, he became the best thief. Braje Prasida, Navanita Choram. He steals butter. Steals clothes of gopis also. Now he stole the jewel present in the heart of Radhaji. And now when he stole that, his complexion changed. See, the thief comes at night, it's completely dark. As soon as he touched the jewels, the alarms went on, lights on. So in the same way, Krishna, he came in the dark complexion, and as soon as he touched the wealth, he became Sachinandan Gaur. As soon as he became Sachinandan Gaur Hari, reactions come, and he became mad. Krishna Keshav, Krishna Keshav, Krishna Keshav, Rakshamam, Ram Raghav, Ram Raghav, Ram Raghav, Pahimam. Continuously crying. His all joints of the body, they open up, and the body becomes so tall. Sometimes the joints, they just get shrunk, and then he becomes like a tortoise. Hey, Matra Dine Dine, Swarupa Damodar Sane.
Swarupa Ramananda Sane.
Swarupa Ramananda Sane. Nij Bhav Karina
Abhare Vishnu
Jala Hare. Bhitare Anand Hare.
Krishna Prem Adbhut
Charitra.
Aisi Dasha Ho Jai.
Such is the state. Whose state? Mahaprabhu. And then he is crying continuously day and night. But it's not about stealing. Krishna actually won here. In all pastimes, try to understand this. Underline this. In every pastime, Radhaji wins and Krishna gets defeated. But in this pastime, in this stealing pastime, Krishna got victorious and Radhaji lost. But in this defeat, Radhaji actually became victorious. In this defeat, Radhaji actually became victorious. Radhaji does not want it to get stolen, and Krishna became a great thief and he wanted to steal. He stole, he became successful. And then, becoming Sachinandan Gaurhari, preaching everywhere in the whole world this Harinam Sankirtan, he is glorifying Radhaji. So here, this is the victory of Radhaji. All glories to Radhaji. This Mahaprabhu, this is what Krishna wants. This is what Radhaji, Krishna thinks that I want to canvas these moods of Radhaji that she hides. That's why it has been said. Mahaprabhuji, that means that Krishna, he showed this pastime in the form of Sachinandan Gaur Hari, where there is such strong meeting that Antar Krishna Bahir Gaur, inside there is Krishna and outside Gaur, such deep meeting, and after such deep meeting, there is great sign of separation. Meeting in separation and separation in meeting. And in this Anvya Vyatirek, what's the real cause? Radhaji's glories. Real cause is to show glories of Radhaji. I think 7 days this shloka itself will take. And that's why I said, Vastu Nirdeshatma, this first shloka, what thing is given in Bhagavad Ji, that is actually showed here. And this is Ashraya Jati. Radhaji's glory is described here by her disciple, that is Shukadev. Shukadev Goswami. In Bhagavad Ji, everywhere Shri Shuk's point has been said, about Shukadev Goswami it has been said. So, Shukadev Goswami himself glorifies Radhaji. From where it started? Said that there is a tree. On the branch of that tree, there is a fruit, that is mango, which is the king of all fruits. Now, this mango falling from the branch of Narayan and came on the branch of Brahma. And from Brahma's branch, it came on Naradji's branch. From Naradji's branch, it fell on Vedvyasji's branch. And from Vedvyasji's branch, as soon as it was about to fall, there was a parrot sitting on that branch, that is Shuk. Parrot. So on the branch of mango tree, if the eagle sit, eagle does not eat mango. Eagle sees where is meat. So the eagle wants meat. If on that same branch of mango tree, if the crow sits, he will search for garbage. He does not want mango, he wants garbage. On that branch of mango tree, if pigeon sits, he search for the female pigeon. He does not want mango, he wants, he is very lusty, so he wants only female pigeon. and on that branch of mango tree, if the parrot sits, at once the parrot bows down and with the beak it tastes that mango hanging. It does not actually taste it, but actually adds to the taste of mango, because that mango which gets touched by the beak of parrot, that mango becomes much more sweeter. So Bhagavad Ji is in itself very sweet because it's glories of Radha. But when Shuk Pakshi, Shuk Parrot, his disciple, her disciple, Shukdev, when he puts his beak on that mango, the mango becomes much and much sweeter. That mango becomes much, much, much more sweeter. This is like God gift. You eat honey. If I say what is honey, you will be surprised. Honey is actually the saliva of honeybee. So we actually eat saliva of honeybees. But the saliva is so sweet. And if that honeybee just bite us, sting us, then it will be so painful. And when we take its saliva, it becomes very honey, like very sweet. Cow eats grass. Grass does not have milk inside it. Grass. Cow eats grass and gives milk. In the same way, parrot. Such sweetness in the beak that whatever fruit it touches becomes more sweet. And this is not an ordinary parrot. This is Shri Shuk, Shuk of Radha Ji. As soon as that mango was about to fall from Vyas Ji's branch, Shuk at once held that mango and added sweetness, so much sweetness, so much sweetness, that, oh my friends, just keep drinking, keep drinking. This is not mango shake, this is not mango juice. This is Bhagavat Ras. And till when you drink? Rasamalyam. This is the house of Rasa. Moho raho rasika, bhovi bhavuka. Just keep drinking, keep drinking, keep drinking. Don't get satisfied. Always stay non-satisfied, unsatisfied. And that's why this Bhagavat Katha is such that Shukadeva Goswami described, that the one who gets satisfied in this, then the one who is not satisfied, that person keeps drinking. This is that thing which makes you more unsatisfied. The one who gets satisfied, that means he is useless. And the one who stayed unsatisfied, who wants more, 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 that person only can actually relish it. This is the rasa of Naam and Bhagavat. That's why Nityam Bhagavatam Sevaya. Every day, eternally, you should read Bhagavad Ji. Oh, so many people come in the house, there is so much pain. Please give us such solutions. Should we do Somvar, Monday fasting, or what should we do?
शुक्रवार तो संतोषी मास है, वो कहाँ है, कहाँ संतोष है ये भी नहीं पता। शनिवार को शनिदेव, रविवार को एक दिन तो चलता ही है, सूर्य की पूजा कोई नहीं करता। शनिवार रविवार को सब रमन बिहारी जी में आते हैं। कोई एक दिन छोड़ा नहीं, कितने उपाय कर लो। मंगल चाहते हैं, मंगल चाहते हैं, मंगल चाहते हैं भाई। मंगलम भगवान विष्णु, मंगलम मधुसूदन। मंगल कहाँ है? मंगल भवन और मंगल हारी। भगवान के नाम में, भागवत जी में। घर में भागवत जी पढ़ो आदर के साथ, भगवान नाम करो, सारा मंगल तो घर में आ गया।
Read Bhagavad Ji in your house. All auspiciousness will come. No need to do any other fastings like this. In the morning, in the house program, I was saying this. There are 33 crore Devi Devta, demigods, demigoddess. How many you can worship? 5, 10, 15, 20. Others will say, what I have done wrong. Were there any fault in us? They will just come to you and they will start poking you. Should we not worship? Do worship. But like what? Everyone has some plant in their house. The gardener gives water to the roots or the leaves. If you just put on the leaves and not on the roots, then it will die. And if you put on the roots, then it will not die, it will grow. Everyone knows this. Who is the root of all demigods? Demigoddesses. Krishna. You all have seen Mahabharata in television, right? In whose house there is Mahabharata Granth? Only one, two people. Why? In our Indian family, they say, oh, don't keep Mahabharata in the house. Why? Because keeping Mahabharata, what happens? Mahabharata happens in the house. Fighting happens so much. You not have any Mahabharata Granth in your house, but still you fight in your house. So much fighting. So why are you putting all the fault on this Granth Mahabharata? And I can tell this with guarantee, I can prove this, that everyone has Mahabharata Granth in your house. You will say, how? We have not brought, how you got to know this? So in television when Mahabharata came, how many of you watched? Watched? Why did you watch that? You liked watching that and you don't want to keep the scriptures in your house. Achha. Okay, tell me, how many of you have Bhagavad Gita? Everyone. What is Bhagavad Gita? It's a part of Mahabharata. So, indirectly everyone has kept Mahabharata in their house. So now don't think that, oh, that's why fighting was happening in our house. I should give up Bhagavad Gita also. I should just keep in the temple. Don't take it like that. Why? Don't take it like that. Instead, Mahabharata, in the house in which Mahabharata is there, then there will be no fighting in that house. Okay? Such beautiful descriptions of Krishna's pastimes are there. Inside it, Bhagavad Gita is there. So that's why in that Mahabharata in Kurukshetra, Krishna showed Virat Roop and said, Aham Sarvasya Prabhavo Mata Sarvam Pravartate. Everyone emanates from me. All the demigods, demigoddesses, they appear from me. I am the source of everything. So when we water the roots, that means when we chant holy names, when we chant and have darshan of Raman Bihari Ji, we hear Bhagavat, we follow Ekadashi, all these things, these are like roots. Watering them, everything will get fulfilled. Just by doing Ekadashi, all the fasting will be done. Other fasting, so many different things. Ekadashi fasting, best fasting. पीबत भागवत रसमाले, एवरीडे ड्रिंक दिस नेक्टर. नो नीड टू गो टू एनी प्रीस्ट और एनीथिंग. प्रीस्ट विल से आ नीले वाला ब्लू सफायर, ओके, ग्रीन एमरल्ड.
आपके घर में तो सुख शांति होगी ना
वो पंडित जी. You must be very happy in your house. Panditji say, I also am suffering. Why don't you wear it? So the Panditji says, no, this is just to tell others. वी डू नॉट गेट मनी. पंडित जी सो पुअर. ऑन द डेज ऑफ श्राद्ध गो हियर देयर. So why are you poor? You also can wear munga, some stone. No, this is not the thing. The thing that you attain by reading Bhagavat, by doing Naam, taking initiation from Guru, then auspiciousness will come at once. Because auspiciousness is present there where the Lord is there. Everyone wants Lakshmi, everyone wants money. Tell honestly, everyone wants wealth or not? But nobody wants the Lakshmipati Narayan. Because if Narayan comes, then we have to worship him. But can the wife stay without husband? No. Sita ji can stay without Ram? No. Lakshmi can stay without Vishnu? No. Radha ji cannot stay without Krishna. That's why just serve Thakurji in your house. Serve Krishna and Ramji. You don't have to bring Lakshmi. Lakshmi will just run like anything and come to you. And if you just worship Lakshmi, Lakshmi is sitting with her Prabhu. Your words will not reach there. Celebrate Diwali. On Diwali, worship Lakshmi Ganesh. What happens on the day of Diwali? Jao, Ramji returned.
Diwali hai Ramji ke liye. कौन अपने घर में राम की पूजा करता है उसे बताना तो ईमानदारी से. ये दो चार पांच लोग पूजा करते हैं लक्ष्मी गणेश की.
एवरीवन वर्शिप्स लक्ष्मी गणेश.
मतलब नहीं.
सो इट्स अबाउट राम जी.
प्रसंग है सीता राम जी का.
द दिवाली इज the festival of Ramji, but everyone worships Lakshmi Ganesh. There is no logic in this at all. Why we just want to selfish, just gain selfish motives? That oh, Lakshmi, just come and give us wealth. Let the money come and let all the inauspiciousness go away by Ganesh. Who said? People, everyone say that Samudra Manthan happened at that day. So there is no point of worshipping Lakshmi Ganesh ji. If you want to worship Sita Ram, Radha Krishna. And if you want to worship Lakshmi, then worship Lakshmi Narayan. You know, the vehicle of Lakshmi is owl. She comes for some days and makes us an owl and then leaves. Chanchala Lakshmi. There is another Lakshmi which is called Mahalakshmi. Who is this Mahalakshmi? The one who stays with Narayan. Her vehicle is not owl, her vehicle is Garuda. She comes on Garuda. Garuda is great devotee. And she stays with husband Narayan. She is not chanchala, she is not restless. This Lakshmi, she will come with the husband Narayan. She will bring all auspiciousness also. And other Lakshmi, she is chanchala. She'll sit here, there. She'll just keep moving. And we become so happy. Ah, today is very nice. Fourth day, distress. It's like this. The foundation of all this Lakshmi is Sarva Lakshmi Mai, Devi Krishna Mai Prokta, Radhika Para Devata. Sarva Lakshmi Mai, Sarva Kanti, Sammohini Para. All Lakshmis who worship her. That's Radha ji. So on the day of Diwali, if you worship Radha Krishna, Krishna is the worshipable of all demigods, and Radha Ji is the worshipable of all demigods. All glories to Radha.
सचिदानंद गौर हरि की।